Hey, it's Troy here. Welcome back to the series on the HBC 56 and building new cards. In this one, it's the TMS 9918 that gets a brand new custom PCB thanks to PCBWay. So once again, I'd like to thank the sponsor of this video, PCBWay, who provided the various PCBs for this project. Thanks, PCBWay. So first I'll go over the schematic for the TMS 9918 card. So we'll just take a look here. We've got, of course, the TMS 9918 itself. Now I've used an SRAM with this. So if we just take a look at this. So this Hackaday project by Tom Circuit. He details how to use an SRAM with the TMS 9918. So I've based my design on this, but made a few changes to it. So if we just go back to my schematic. So one of the changes I made was he had used three latches. So for the row, column and data portions, where I'm using a latch for row and column, but for the data I'm just using a bus transceiver. The other change is the delay. So in his design, he was talking about needing a delay for column select, and I found that isn't necessary. Now it might be related to using this bus transceiver for the data byte instead, but I've added the option here, and so with that enabled, it still goes through the multiple inverters to get that column select delay. I think another thing to note is the crystals. Here I'm showing it with 32 picofarad load capacitors. And so when you order the crystal for the TMS 9918, if I just switch to Mouser, so if we search for that frequency, so this is looking at the 10 points, where are we? Yeah, 10.738635. Megahertz crystals, and you'll see some of them are series, and this is something that you want to avoid for this circuit. And so I've found best results with these 32 picofarad load capacitance crystals, and they seem to work quite well. So what else? Address decoding. So in my hand-wired version, I'm using 74688, but I have that connected to a bank of 8 DIP switches to configure the I/O port for the TMS 9918. For this design, just to save on space, I'm keeping the 74688 to decode addresses, but hard coding most of those address lines. So we've only got two options, which are configured with a single jumper. That'll allow me to actually use two of these cards in the future if I wanted to do that. So speaking of that, I've also added a header for external VDP. So we could look at having two of these in tandem, where basically one will overlay on top of the other. Yeah, and so that's about it. This output circuit is mostly taken from Tom Circuit's project. Okay, and so if we skip through to the PCB, again, this one's fairly straightforward. Again, it's a four-layer card, just like my CPU card. I've made provisions to have either a 0.6 or 0.3 inch SRAM. Just by having the extra set of holes here. So I'll just take a look at the 3D view. And again, we'll go for black. So this is the card, which I'll order through PCBWay. And looks pretty good. So yeah, hopefully I'll have that in around a week or so. Another thing to note too is the orientation. So all of the chips have pin one to the left here, except for the SRAM, which has it to the right. And I did that just for ease of routing. So there's something to keep in mind. So once again, I'd like to thank PCBWay for supplying these PCBs. I'll just quickly show you the ordering process. So it's just a matter of going to PCBWay.com, go to Quick Order PCB, add Gerber file, so my 9918. That's it. Everything else looks good. So this it's a four layer board, so I need to go in and fill out my layer names. Black. And save to cart. Okay, and so yeah, wait about a week and see what we get. So the cards are here. Let's take a look at the TMS 9918 cards. As I said in the CPU card video, they were packaged well and look really good. And so I'll just pull out one of these and yeah, no surprise here. They look great, just like the CPU cards, super sharp. And awesome, yeah, great job PCBWay. Time to start building. So first I'll gather up the parts that I need. So we've got the decoupling caps, the double row pin headers we need to connect to the bus, and the various sockets. So we've got quite a few ICs on this card, from the TMS9918 to the SRAM and all of its support chips. We've got the yellow RCA jack for the composite output and all of the support hardware for output. Yeah, as always, I'll start with the lower profile items first. So we've got resistors and the crystal. Make sure the sockets are in flush, so solder the corners, have a look, and then solder the rest of the pins. For those who have asked about my soldering iron, so it's a TS100 portable soldering iron. It just runs off of DC voltage, anywhere from 12 to 21 volts. And so I'm running it on a 21 volt laptop charger, and it's a fantastic little soldering iron. It heats up super fast. I'll put a link to a unlisted video showing how fast this thing heats up. But for this kind of work, it's just a perfect little iron, and yeah, I love it. So now the RCA jack, and silly me, that's a little bit of a higher profile component to be adding prior to the double row pin headers. So I had to sort of take care to make sure that they weren't too high or low. Again, I use a female socket just to make sure the two lots of male pin headers line up. Now adding the pin headers for the various jumpers, and again I like to use a female socket just to hold onto it and make sure that it's straight. So that's the board done, just checking a few of the connections and clean up the back. And next up we'll populate the board and give it a test. I spoke too soon, needed to add the electrolytic capacitor and the load capacitors for the crystal as well. Okay, let's get populating. So throw in the TMS9918, the SRAM, and all of the support chips. Job done, let's test. So once again, out with the old and in with the new. I'll start with a cut down version of the machine. I've taken out most of the cards except for the CPU and RAM-ROM card. And I'll throw in the new TMS9918 and we'll see how it goes. Brilliant. That looks like a win. So unlike the CPU card, this one looks to have worked first go. That's great. So I couldn't just leave it there. Given this is a graphics card, I thought I'd better at least show a game working. So here's Breakout. I have shown this game briefly in my channel before, but as always, all the code for this game is in the GitHub repository. You can even try it yourself in my emulator, so the emulator you can use online in your web browser, and you can play this Breakout game. So I'll leave it there for this video. The next one will be the RAM-ROM card, which has 64K of RAM and 32K of ROM. It has a couple of tricks up its sleeve as well, which I'll get into in the next video. Also, on the TMS9918, I'll do more coding videos on this in the future as well. All right, thanks for watching. See ya.